going from the Citadel game to the bye week to Temple, what positive changes did you see from your offense?
Our TFLs were down. I think we're on guys a lot better. I think our understanding of what we're doing is growing, getting much, much better. We were really multiple in the things that we were running. You know, we were much more balanced, much more running back oriented run game. Not as much, you know, total spread with the quarterback running. I think, you know, that was a good adjustment for us. I think we, you know, we made a bunch of plays on the edge. We, you know, we threw some balls down the field. The wideouts played really, really well. I think, you know, there was some good development in the pass game. We left a lot of things out there. But I think it's just a week-to-week project of getting better and really understanding what we're doing and just the flow of the game. And, you know, we did – when you go back on Sunday, you know, we have the ability to go back and watch everything on Sunday and be really, really critical of what we're doing. And we did a lot of really good stuff. And so there's a lot of stuff to build on. There's a lot of things we got to get corrected. And, you know, I really don't think that the score was indicative of how we played. I mean, you know, you cannot turn the ball over three times in a red zone. I don't care who you are, you're gonna struggle. And I think if we get that first one in there, I think it's a different game. I think we kind of, you know, play with a little bit more moxie and kind of, you know, we're not playing from behind, you know, the whole game. And so I think the turnovers were critical. We got to get that cleaned up. But I think that there was a lot of stuff to build from. We ran the ball well. TFLs were down. You know, they. You know, we had to throw it a bunch, and our protection held up pretty well. We were on the right guys. Sometimes, you know, the number 90 kid is a really good pass rusher, so sometimes, you know, we were in one-on-one situations. But I thought we held up pretty well there. We were on all the right guys. So I think just our understanding and our development of what we're doing was a lot better.
With James, it really seemed like, even though I think he was 10 for 24, but he seemed like he knew where he wanted to go, and it seemed like the right decision maybe overthrew it, or maybe just that execution wasn't mm-hmm. really there at times. When you went back and looked at it, what was kind of your assessment of the way he played that second half?
Inconsistent. Electric, as good as anybody in the country. And then the next play, you know, threw it into the third seats, you know, third row. So he's got to be more consistent with where he's throwing the ball. And his understanding has grown tremendously from where we were in the spring, which still needs to take 10 more steps before he really understands what he's doing and he's really going to be prolific. But he made some dynamic throws. I mean, you know, as good as, you know, he can throw it. And a couple of those comebacks that he threw on the move and Jalen snagged the ball, I mean, those were NFL throws. So he has, you know, real arm talent and he's very athletic, but he's got to become more mature in how he prepares, how he understands, how he studies, how he gets out there. And, you know, he came in yesterday and he was, you know, he's kind of like, you know, we got to get this right. He wanted to come in and watch it, so we sat down for a while, and we went over all the plays that he had, the good, the bad, and the ugly. And then I called the same play today, the first play of coming out that he missed, that we went over last night, and he put his foot in the ground. We ran it out. He threw the out for the first down, coming out, moved the chains. The offense came off the field. That's the kind of growth you're going to have with a young Q, you know. And, you know, there's going to have to be a lot of patience with a young guy like that who has really good understanding of who he is athletically, right? But sometimes he's like a wild stallion, you know what I mean? He's like, oh, he's all, you know, hyped up. And you can't play quarterback like that. You know what I mean? It's got to be one play, go to the next play, go to the next play. And, you know, once he settles down and is really more comfortable in what we're doing, I think he'll be dynamic.
It's you know, with an offensive line, it's obviously coaches like to have five guys mm-hmm. and stick with it. What's that like, you know, with as many walk-ons? Coach Collins was alluding to
the Yeah, it's difficult because the whole thing, if you're cohesive with the guys, those five guys, when they play together, they know all the calls, they communicate, they know each other's patterns, so they know how they're going to – they can feel them – bumping off of each other. They know how to communicate with each other. They know who's, all right, if this guy does this, I'm going to take it. So there's a lot of pieces that are moving. And, you know, like even, you know, Kenny Cooper, you know, being in there solidifies the whole group. You know, he's like the rock in there. He communicates everything. He's tough. He's strong. He does all the things. But, you know, then he's got a bum hip. You know what I mean? So he doesn't feel great. You know, so he's not even playing up to the elite level. So when you start moving all the pieces around, you know, it's just a learning process of guys having to play with each other. And, you know, the guys went in there and scrapped. I mean, Will Lay had to get in there again. And, you know, there were no snap issues. You know, he was on the right guy and went in there and fought his tail off. And, you know, really for the most part, you know, did a really good job. We ran the ball well in the second half. We spun it around. I thought we protected a little bit better. And, again, when you get in a red zone, you just have to punch the ball in. And, you know, I thought we, besides the turnovers, I thought we probably left three scores on the board throwing it. And you have to be able to identify what that is, why that happened, and, you know, get it corrected. And, you know, the analogy I used with the guys today is, you know, there's a reason why a rearview mirror is this big and a windshield is this big, right? You want to look back and see what happened, and you want to keep it corrected, but you have the whole world in front of you when you're driving a car, right? So we have 8 games left. We have a huge amount of what we're doing left. We have to continue to look forward. We have to look in our rearview mirror and understand why things are happening, what happened, how do we correct it. We corrected it on Sunday. Like, you know, Coach Thacker mentioned, I think Coach Collins mentioned also, you know, on Sundays, it's Tell the Truth Sunday, right? We come in and we say, look, this was really good. This was really bad. This was a crappy call by the offensive coordinator. This was a great job by this guy. This was really cool. We made this adjustment. Okay, this is why this happened. We all take ownership of what's going on, and then we move on to the next day. And then we go out Sunday night, we practice, we tear the Band-Aid off, we go, and then we're back at it. But, you know, that's the piece of, you know, the pieces that I think we're building on and James is building on.
You kind of answered some of it, but I'm just kind of curious, as a coach, when you do have that many turnovers, that kind of maybe set the tone for the game. As a coach, what is it that you do in your first practice, kind of dissect those turnovers and work with your offense?
Yeah, so the first thing we did Sunday was a ball security circuit. So everybody rotated through, you know, and you're stripping at the ball. You're running through a gauntlet of bags. We're teaching guys how to protect the ball, how to carry the ball. You know that, you know, your wrist should always be above your elbow. The ball should be tucked in. You can't leave the ball down here. Guys are stripping at it. We're whacking at them with bags. Coaches are screaming at them. You know, just put them in a chaos type of deal. And it's a difference between having a ball down here and getting hit or having the ball right here. The ball's not going to go anywhere if the ball's up by your chin. You know, and if you're using your offhand to protect yourself, you know, now you're not letting guys get into your body. So that was the first thing that we talked about. And we talked about protecting the ball always. And then, you know, the pick that we threw in the red zone, you know, we got a different look than we had gotten on the previous plays. And the quarterback, you know, we said, all right, if you get this look, throw this ball. Throw it here, right? And it was a different look. And, you know, James moving forward is not going to throw the ball down the middle of the field when it's free safety covering the middle of the field. He's going to go back to the other side. So we worked on a lot of those things too. It's like, okay, what is the identification of the defense? All right. Don't throw the ball down the middle of the field when there's a middle of the field safety, right? Oh, okay, I got it. You know, but those are the things, again, you got to learn that. And sometimes the thing that stinks about playing quarterback is that only until you have to live through it do you really fully understand how to make the adjustments, you know? And he did a great job protecting himself, sliding the protections. And, you know, but you can't throw, you know, we punch any of those in and throw the other ones. I mean, you guys saw it on tape, right? I mean, we run out, we throw a go ball. Adonicus Sanders runs an out and up right by the guy. James gets hit right as he's throwing it, overthrows it a little bit. You know, there was a couple where we banged the post, we ran by a guy, we might have slid off the protection or or that like that, you know. So I thought we had some really explosive plays. We did some good things throwing it. We missed on a bunch of explosives. And then you just have to say, hey, look, you can't miss on these again, and this is the continued growth.
A couple more for
Pat. You sort of touched on one of the things. It seems like for what you want to do offensively, that James maybe has the arm for that to make those tight window throws and that kind of thing. Is it a thing where you just have to kind of live with his growing pains here a little bit and let him kind of see and make those mistakes and learn from it to help build the program long term?
Yeah, so, you know, the great thing, you know, with that, with the quarterbacks is that Tobias is an elite level guy, and you see when he gets out of the pocket, he's dangerous, right? He threw the ball well moving out of the pocket. He runs the ball tremendous, right? But he had a little hot feet and he was a little antsy in there throwing the ball in the pocket. The thing with James is he'll stand and deliver, right? You know, he wants to throw the ball. Sometimes he wants to throw the ball deep every time. We got to get that straightened out a little bit. He did have Tyler Davis open in the flat a few times and he didn't throw it. So we are trying to call balls to get to Tyler. And he throws it down the field. But, you know, when you have young quarterbacks, it's understanding what your offensive play is. Okay, these are the routes, and this is the protection. That's where it starts. And then you say, okay, versus this defense, this is where you go with the ball. But the thing is, they don't always tell you what they're running, right? So then you have to read it. And what you thought was cover two, now that corner bailed, and you should throw the out. But he didn't throw the out because he was cover two, and then he went backside. And, you know, so it's just seeing it over and over and over, and then coming back and having productive meetings and saying, listen, you got to watch this safety. When this safety does this, you're going to do this. This is where you go with the ball. And when he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, he threw some really nice throws, you know, and we showed some things there, you know. But then when you go back and you watch it again, you're like, big guy, why didn't you just throw the out? Oh, yeah, I should have thrown the out. I didn't see that. You know, so, you know, he's a redshirt freshman who was running a triple option offense last year who never gunned it in high school. You know, they weren't sitting back and gunning the ball around. So, you know, you're really starting from, you know, a really elementary level with the drop back passing game. And, you know, we maxed it up. We threw it deep a few times. You know, the cool thing in, you know, I guess the in vogue thing in college football now offensively, like Coach Thacker was alluding to, is you just max protect it and throw as far as you can, right? Because there's guys playing a lot of man coverage because they're trying to overload the box to play the run, right? So, we got into a bunch of that, too, and we took some shots. And, you know, we hit a few. We missed a few. We had a few wide open that we should have taken. So, there's some growth there, and we just got to continue to grow. I mean, I think we're on the right track, and I think, you know, you can have a special player with number four throwing the ball around.
Kind of last one.
You mentioned about the protection that, you know, guys are in the right place and, you know, so you're reading the blitzes and so forth, right? Obviously, there were some challenges when those guys were in the right place, given that, you know, you have what you have and you know, that would seem less a matter about knowing what to do but just being able to do it. Just
sure.
How do you kind of handle that and go forward for the rest of the year?
So don't put them in bad situations. Right, my job and Coach Key's job and Coach Choice's job is to figure out who's the eraser on defense, you know, and who can we not leave singled up on a consistent basis and still be successful. And how do you do that, you know? So do you park somebody next to a guy and chip them? Do you double chip both ends, you know? But then you're losing guys in a route. So then you have to figure out what those routes are. Do you max protect? You know, fake a run, get seven guys in there, and throw the ball down the field. Do you throw solo routes? You know, do you just say, all right, we're going to pack it all in there, and we're going to throw the ball to one dude, and you got to go win and scheme it up that way? Do you empty them out? And you say, okay, there's only a finite group of guys now who can come, right? So it's a little easier on the queue. Look, they only have these dudes. Everybody else is out there, right? So protect these guys. And, you know, can you screen it? Can you sprint? Do you run nakeds? Do you just run quick game? Catch, rock, and throw a hitch? You know, and then just be variable, right? So, like, if you're, like, old school and you're in four wides and you're chucking the ball down the field every day, you're exposing your O-line. You know, that's not what we did. You know, we were a good mix of seven-man, six-man, screens, sprints, you know, that type of thing. And that's what you have to continue to do. And at some point, you know, those guys are going to have to be in one-on-ones, and they're going to have to win. And I thought for the most part they were pretty good. The thing, you know, one of the things was that the quarterback was just, you know, he was a little bit antsy, so he was getting real deep. And now the guys are running off the edge on us, so we have to fix that. That's just another thing. And he doesn't even know it. Like, I'm like, bro, you're back there like 19 yards. You're not going to be protected, right? Get up in the pocket, step up in the pocket. And you saw the evolution of that throw. He was back there. We ran two in balls, right? And he stepped up and he stuck one down the middle of the field to Jalen Camp. He never would have made that throw a month ago. So it's just a continual process. And then we have to be able to be smart enough to do that. And the other thing, Ken, is stay out of third and long, right? Stay out of third and long. So any of us could protect when it's third and four, right? Because I have 4,000 routes we can run, right? It's third and 14, you know, now you got to hold up and, you know, it's a different game. So you got to be on schedule first and second down. That alleviates your ability to have to stand there and sit in the pocket and throw the balls down the field past the sticks.
Okay. Thank you, Coach.